Hello, GCC. We are back for our second video in chapter 10. I'm going to pick up right where we left off, talking about barium hydroxide's molar mass. The last thing we did is add it up. There's a couple of things we need to note that are very important with molar masses. The unit, again, is grams per mole. I mentioned that in the first video. It's not just grams, it's grams per mole, because we're adding up the mass for 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd units or molecules or atoms when we add up a molar mass. Also, when we're doing the molar mass for a compound, we're adding the atoms' masses together. So we're adding, so that means we need to follow the rules for addition. You round based on the fewest decimal places. Now, in our Chem 130 periodic table, almost everything has two decimal places. So your molar mass will also have two decimal places. Remember, I mentioned the oxygen is 16.00. Don't forget those zeros. They're significant. So there's two decimal places there. So when you add oxygen to something, you better end up with two decimal places as well. All right, so let's move on to new material. Let's do some calculations using the mole. Get your calculators ready. We can use Avogadro's number as a conversion factor. So it is 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd atoms or molecules over 1 mole. Or we can flip that and do 1 mole over 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd atoms or molecules. Let's see how this works with a typical question number one. How many calcium atoms are in 0.250 moles of calcium? Now, if I had said 1 mole, we wouldn't even have to do a calculation because we know 1 mole is 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd atoms. But we don't have 1 mole. We have a fourth of a mole, don't we? We have 0.250 moles. That's not 1 mole. So we need to do a calculation. Start with what you're given. We are given 0.250 moles of calcium. So we're starting with moles. So look at our two conversion factors up there. Because we started with moles, do we want moles to be on the top or the bottom of our conversion factor? You're correct if you said the bottom. So we need to put 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd atoms over 1 mole in this calculation. It'll look something like that. So we got our 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd atoms over 1 mole. Why is it atoms? Well, I'm talking about calcium. That's just an element. It's not diatomic. So the calcium is just single atoms. So calcium is made up of atoms. That's why I chose atoms. Calcium's not made up of molecules. There's no other atom there that it's bonded to. So calcium is just made up of atoms. So that's why I said 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd atoms over 1 mole. Anyway, the moles cancel, right? And we're left with atoms. So you punch this into your calculator. Let's remind ourselves how to do these scientific numbers. 0.250 times 6.02. Don't hit times 10. Instead, find your exponent button, EE or EXP. You may have to hit the second function to get to it. Hit your exponent EE button, then type in the 23 and hit equals. And we should have 1.505, and then over in the corner, it's times 10 to the 23rd. But sig figs, we started with 3. 6.02 has 3. It's a measurement. It counts. 6.02 has 3 sig figs. So we need to round that to 1.51 times 10 to the 23rd calcium atoms. The unit is atoms. We need a unit. Moles canceled. Okay, if you need help with your calculator, ask your instructor. All right, number two, calculate the moles of 3.75 times 10 to the 27th molecules of oxygen gas. Notice this is molecules because oxygen is diatomic. It is one, two oxygen atoms bonded together. So that makes it a molecule because we have two atoms bonded together. So oxygen comes in molecules compared to calcium, which comes in atoms. So oxygen is molecules. Start with what you're given. We are given 3.75 times 10 to the 27th molecules of O2. Diatomic, right? O2. Now, because we started with molecules, do we want molecules to be on the top or the bottom of our conversion factor? On the bottom, right? So we need the 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd molecules on the bottom and one mole on top. Looks like this. Molecules cancels out and we're left with moles. Is that what we wanted? Calculate the moles. Yes, we wanted moles. So let's enter this in our calculator correctly. 3.75 exponent button 27 times 1 divided by 6.02 exponent button 23 equals 6229.23588 is what the calculator shows. Sig figs. We started with 3 and 6.02 has 3, so we need 3 sig figs. It is 6,229. 29 rounds to 30, not 3. So it is 6,230, not 623. 6,230 moles of O2. Good job. All right. Carrying on. Let's do a few more calculations and we'll be done. We're going to do grams to moles now using our molar mass as a conversion factor. All right. How many grams is 1.667 moles of oxygen gas? Okay, we're going to use a molar mass, which is the grams per mole, as a conversion factor. We can write it grams per mole, or we can write it moles on top over grams, depending on which we want to cancel out, the moles or the grams. So number one, start with what we're given. 1.667 moles of oxygen gas. What is oxygen? We just said diatomic. Two of them, two oxygen atoms bonded together. It's O2. How many grams is 1.667 moles of oxygen gas? 1.667 moles O2 is what we start with. We start with moles. So do we want moles on top or bottom? On the bottom to cancel out. So our molar mass is going to be grams on top of the mole, one mole. We need to add up the molar mass of oxygen, O2. Find oxygen in your periodic table. There it is. It is 16.00. Is that the molar mass of oxygen? No, we just said it's diatomic. So it's times 2 because there's 2 atoms in oxygen. So that would be 16.00 times 2, which is 32.00 grams per mole. Looks like this. There we go. Moles cancel out. We're left with grams. Is that what we wanted? How many grams? Yes. Okay, so 1.667 moles, put it in your calculator, 1.667 times 32.00 divided by 1, it's just 1 mole, equals how many sig figs? Everything has 4. 1.667 has 4, 32.00 has 4. Remember, it's not 32, it's 32.00. 4 sig figs. So we need 4 sig figs. 53.34 grams, O2, is the final answer. So again, we're using the molar mass as a conversion factor. Let's try one more together, then I'm going to let you work the last two on your own. How many moles is 45 grams of silver? How many moles is 45 grams of silver? Start with what you know, 45 grams silver. What silver? Ag. I hope you said Ag. So we're starting out with 45 grams Ag. We're starting with grams. So do we want grams on top or bottom in that molar mass? Well, this time we want grams on the bottom. find Ag in the periodic table. There it is. It's 107.87 grams per mole, but we need that 107.87 grams on the bottom. Looks like this. 45 grams of silver, one mole on top of the 107.87 grams. Grams cancel. We get moles. Sig figs. Well, 107.87 has 5, but 45 grams only has 2. So 2 sig figs, 0.42. Let's put that in our calculator. 45 divided by 107.87 equals 0.41716 8814. Big long number. But again, we need 2 sig figs, so it rounds to 0.42 moles of silver. All right, I want you to work on the next two problems during our break. We'll come back to those on the next video. Number 3, how many grams is 0.0554 moles of water? And number 4, how many grams is 4.75 times 10 to the 16th atoms of K? You should know what K is. All right, so work those two problems out. Hit pause, and we'll answer them in our next video. Stick with me, GCC. You're doing good. Bye-bye.